HTTPS is easy. So far, we have added HTTPS to the website in less than 5 minutes. We have optimized the HTTPS implementation to get better than bank-grade security. And lastly, we went and fixed all the insecure references with an upgrade insecure request content security policy and automatic HTTPS rewrites on Cloudflare. This last bit is a bit trickier, but I would be remiss if I didn't mention it. And to explain what we're doing here, we need to start by understanding what happens when you use Cloudflare with your website. I'm on the support page and they talk about 4 different SSL models I want to explain here. The first is when it's off, so the user connects to Cloudflare without any encryption, and then Cloudflare connects to the server without any encryption. The second is flexible. The user connects to Cloudflare with encryption, so they see the padlock and the secure text in their browser, but then Cloudflare connects to the server with no encryption. So there's a part of the network there that is not protected. The third model is full SSL. So the user connects to Cloudflare encrypted again, Cloudflare connects to the server encrypted, but it doesn't require a valid certificate on the server. There is no certificate validation. If someone can get in the middle of that traffic and inject their own certificate, they would be able to intercept requests. That's far less risky in most circumstances than the connection between the user and Cloudflare, so this is still a very good model, but we really must cover how to encrypt it all the way. And that brings us to full SSL strict, and this does require a valid certificate on the server. So let's do this. Let's jump over to the Cloudflare dashboard. We're on the crypto tab. I'm going to change our configuration here to full strict. Now let's have a look at the website once I've done this, because at present I do not have a valid certificate for this domain name on my origin website. I'm going to reload the page. And now we see an error because of the invalid certificate. So the way we need to solve this is to get a valid certificate on the origin website. So this is whatever hosting provider already has your website on it. That's where we need a valid certificate. Now we can do this for free as well by jumping back to Cloudflare and scrolling down to the origin certificate section. I'm going to go and create a certificate. I'm going to leave all the defaults where they are and go to the next screen. I'm going to select the entire origin certificate, copy it onto the clipboard, open up a notepad window, then paste that in and save it as httpsiseasy.pem. And that's going to be without a TXT extension. So I'll save that one. Then I'll jump down to the private key. And I'm going to copy that private key and again open up another notepad window, paste it in, save it as httpsiseasy.key. And again, no file extension. So now I've got the 2 files saved. It's a question of what does my hosting provider need in terms of certificate format. Now this is going to differ host by host. I'm running on Azure, and when I jump over there and have a look at what's required for me to upload a certificate, it needs a PFX. So I'm going to go and copy a command that I've prepared onto the clipboard, drag over a command window, and paste it in. This will compile everything into a PFX format. So let's run that. It's going to need a password, so I'm going to go and copy one I prepared before, paste that in, run it, and also paste that password back in again. I now have a PFX file that I can upload into Azure. So I'm going to go and select that from my local file system and also paste in the password I used when I created the PFX. I'm going to upload that into Azure now. And that's done, certificate successfully uploaded. And finally, I'm going to add an SSL binding. So this is where I'm going to attach that certificate to the domain name of this website, httpsiseasy.com. The certificate is the one that I just uploaded. And now I'm going to add the binding. Right, that has now succeeded, which means that if I go back to my HTTPSiseasy website, the one that was failing after we rolled over to full strict, I can now reload that page and that comes up successfully. And that is as secure as we can make it. We've now got full HTTPS between the browser and Cloudflare, but then also between Cloudflare and the origin site. So all segments of the network traffic are now secure. That was a little bit more mucking around than the first three parts of the series, but I wanted to make sure I covered it here so that those who really do want to go as secure as possible can do so easily by following these steps. HTTPS is easy, and I hope this series makes the adoption of it easy so that the web moves towards a more secure by default position.